Hey guys, how's it going? Follipops here, and of course I'm here to do a video. Now, I mentioned before that I was going to do a video on Ninja driving survival kit for some returnees, and I got some comments asking me to please do the video on tips on how to drive in Nigeria. Now, some of these tips can be seen as exaggerated and comic, but let me tell you, I am being deadly serious with some of the tips that I'm giving you. Like, seriously, don't think I'm joking, because these are all based on experiences I've had driving on the roads in Nigeria, Lagos to be precise, Lagos, yeah. So keep tuned for my tips. Okay, so those things that you see on the car on the side, normally called side mirrors, that you think are meant to be used, yeah, don't think people use that in Nigeria. So my number one tip is never assume that people use the mirrors in their cars. Those things on the side of the cars are literally decorations. I'm telling you, don't think people use their side mirrors. I'm telling you, God loves Lagos especially. God loves Nigeria, but Lagos especially, because I know so many people who drive their cars and they have never even looked into their side mirrors. It's just, they will just switch from these lanes. So do not assume that thing on the side of the car called side mirrors are used by all drivers. So be 100% on board whenever you're driving. Do not think, just because you're indicating you want to turn left, that someone in front of you is going to be looking behind you to know you're going to turn into that lane. You best just pray. You best just pray. Let me just explain. Yeah, don't assume everybody uses their mirrors. Okay, you have to be 100% on board. That's my first tip. Another tip. You're going down a one-way road. One way never means anything in Nigeria. One way, you know, I'm going to talk from Lagos. One way never means anything in Lagos. I have been down a one-way road and I've seen someone coming at me. Yeah. Do you want me to make it even more interesting? I've been on a motorway and it has been the other side of the road and there's been a car coming towards me in the evening. So always be alert when driving, especially if it's in the night time. Always be alert. Have your lights on. I never assume just because the road says it's one way that there's only going to be cars going your way. No, you'll see someone coming your way sometimes. So always be alert when you are driving on the road. Another tip, if the sun goes down, and we're talking about 6, 7, put your lights on full beam. There's no such thing as normal light, night light, or anything. Full beam all the way. It is a local trend and tip that once it gets evening, full beam lights come on. You don't want to be caught off guard when you're driving and someone's coming towards you and the full beam is in your eyes. You better give it back to them. You better give that full beam back to them. People think it's a joke. People think it's an actual joke. But there's been times when I'm driving and I have my light on normal beam. Like the normal, I don't know what it's called. I don't know the technical term. And I'm coming and the person's on the coming towards me. And he's got, me too, I just put it on. You think it's fine? I'll give it back to you. Jokes aside, full beam is needed for the roads as well. Because when you're driving, you never know what new pothole you're going to come across. So you got to need that. You need that full beam. You need that for me. Tip number four, never assume that you know a way. Never, ever, ever get used to taking a way. What I mean by that is, you might travel on a road every single day for 5 days the same way and think, this road is fine, I know it, I'm going to just go fast and I know the way. Never assume, because there's going to be a new pothole popping up. Another pothole popping up, never assume, because you could just be going and thinking, yeah, this is my road, I always travel on it, I know this way, boom, psh, your tire bursts because there's a new pothole that's formed. So always be careful when traveling your normal routes, okay? Never assume that the road is fine just because you traveled it yesterday and it was fine and smooth. Tomorrow you will see a new pothole, I guarantee you. So never assume that you know your journey, and that goes for traffic as well. Never, ever, 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 ever assume just because you go this way every day for the past 2 weeks and there's never been traffic that tomorrow there won't be traffic. Always be alert. Tip number five, leave at least 30 minutes, if not more, to go for your journey if you're driving.
Yes. 30 minutes, if not more. Because the chances and likelihood of there being traffic is 99.9%. Okay? Depending on your area. Tip number 6, drive like you're the only sane person on the road. If you're driving in the streets of Lagos, you have to drive like you are the only one who has a brain. Chances are, 9 out of the 10 people driving on that road do not know what they're doing. And they will just swerve, and they will just move, and they will not look, and they do not even care, because they're just getting to where they want to go to. Drive like you're the only one with a brain. So never assume if someone's in front of you and they indicate they want to turn left, don't think, oh, this person turned left, let me slow down. You better go around them, behind them, because they might not even turn. They have, might just have the indicators on for like 20 minutes. Yeah. Or don't assume that if someone wants to park on the side of the road, they're going to indicate. Those things on the side called indications are decorations for the car. There's a lot of decorations for cars in Lagos that people don't even know how to use. They don't use it, okay? So if you think that a car's going to be driving in front of you and it's not going to just stop randomly, ooh, you better be alert. You better be alert, because I've been in situations, at least it happens to me twice a week, where I'm driving, and most particularly those things they call downfalls or buses and kekes. You can just be driving and they just stop on the side of the road, no indication, no alert, just stop. So you gotta always be on point. Watch out for those things called buses, kekes, motorbikes. You need to watch out for them. Always leave enough room, because those things, oh my gosh, I call them things because they're so irritating and annoying, especially the buses. The buses are like, drive like they're the only things on the road. Now you need to remember, these buses don't really care about the bus condition, because I mean it's battered and tattered, so they will not care if they hit your car. You need to always leave enough room, because those things can just swerve, you know, it will just move. You might have indicated that you are moving somewhere and the bus might be behind you. It won't care, it won't wait, it won't stop. So you need to be aware of that, okay? Those things do not care whether you're indicating, whether you're waving, whether you're braking, they will still go. So you need to always be aware of those things on the road. Buses, kekes, motorbikes especially, because they like to come and trick you. They like to just come on the side of the road, come on the side of your mirror. You need to always be looking at your mirror. Like, literally, always look in your mirror. Same way they taught us to drive, look in your mirror. Times it by 2, especially when driving in Lagos. Now, this tip is for moving around in Lagos, because I thought it was necessary, just in case someone, you know, needs it. Please, if you are on the road and you happen to come a thing that we know as zebra crossings, do not assume that you can walk and the car will stop. Those things are for decorations, okay? I'm being serious. They are to decorate the road, because if you walk on that thing and assume a car's gonna stop for you, oh Lord. They just put those lines on the road for decoration. You know, someone just thought, ooh, black, white, lines. Ooh, I see it in London. Ooh, I see this thing in London. Ah, let's go put it on my road now. It's decoration, Abby. Mm-mm. And another tip for walkers, if you are crossing a one-way road, look both ways, please. Yeah. Just because it's a one-way road does not mean that is a one-way road. On a more serious note, driving around in Lagos, especially in the evening and things like that, always be careful for police indications, okay? There are times when you have police stopping you, waving you with their torch to slow down because they want to do checks. Never wind down. Unless you're completely sure. Even if you're gonna wind it down a tiny bit, okay? And when you're going, when you're trying to slow down, never stop, just slow down. Because you never know, some people can dress up as policemen, and you've always got to be careful and security conscious, okay? So if someone's police stops you to check, you just wind, you move, don't even wind out, don't even wind down, to be honest. You move slowly, slow down slowly, but still move and creep, smile, and drive off, okay? Because you need to be careful with some people that we have in this system, yeah. I'm not saying it's police, some people can dress up as police, some people can trick people. So you always gotta be alert. Another tip is driving and there's traffic and maybe you know, do not wind down your window when you're driving in this traffic, just for safety reasons, okay? I didn't want to share this story, but I'll just share it. I don't want to scare anyone, but I have been nearly, okay, attacked twice while I was driving, and this was because I wound down my window a bit. Now, in those instances, my AC was messing up, so I wound down my window a bit, and normally if there's traffic and I stop, I always wind up. But in this incident, I was changing lanes, and someone came to my mirror, some guy that said, madam, give me your phone, and I was just there like, oh my gosh. I freeze in these situations. It's not like I freeze and not do anything. I freeze and I'm not there, but I just do something. So I quickly wound up, change lanes, and you know, switch. So never wind down, especially if you're gonna stop. I would just say be confident, because how I learned to drive around, and why everyone, people always ask me, how can you drive in Nigeria? How do you do it? One, my first thing was I had no choice. Yeah. Two, I wasn't gonna start taking bus and everything, because I'm always scared of one chance, and I don't even know how to do that one, so I just don't even try. And three, I found my routes and ways just by getting lost in different places, and always have enough petrol. Always have enough petrol. Always check your oil, always check your water before you go out, because you just never know what new thing is gonna happen. Always watch for the potholes, always watch for the pedestrians crossing, especially at night. Don't assume that they're gonna stop because they see your car, they will just go. So always watch for those things. Yeah, just have confidence, because at the end of the day, everyone's crazy on the road. So you have to be crazy, you have to join them. If you can't beat them, join them, but join them and be better. Like, seriously, it's not even a joke. You have to join them and be better. You have to be crazier than them on the road. Like, I heard this saying, which I completely agree with. If you can drive in Nigeria, you can literally drive anywhere in the world. There's been a time I was on a bridge. Now, you know, on a bridge you have two sides, one goes this way and one comes back. There's a barrier in between and you literally can't cross over. Now, I've been coming towards an area, and because the other side of the road had traffic, I see police coming towards me on the one way direction. Yeah, that's another thing. Police own the road in their cars, so you just be careful of that. Or should I say, they think they own the road in their cars. You just be careful of that. I just packed in as much as I could. I hope this helps you guys out there. As much as some of the things seem crazy, I am genuinely 100% serious with the tips I've given you. Always be alert. Always have courage. And after that, it's a breeze. Nigeria is fun. There's loads of places to explore. Not a lot of things to do though, if you don't have much friends, but yeah, loads of places to explore. And that's it. Yeah. Alright, hope those tips helped you guys. Is there any more I missed off? Yeah, so hope those helped you guys. And stay tuned for more videos from moi. Let me play quick my song of the moment, which I'm absolutely loving.
Ram ting a ling a ling, school bell a ring, time fi go sing, the bell a rang.